Order, order in the house. The two of you, keep your mouth shut. Order, order.
Human beings are so complex.
Do you know? I think you're bloody right.
Really mad people.
Duck down, plane overhead. Well done.
I'm here. I'm not going nowhere.
Good, and pay your bloody bill before you leave the building.
Way at the wind blow high, let the wind blow low.
All of you, listen to me. Listen to me. Respectively.
Are you the gentleman in Sexy Beast?
Yeah, so what? What we can do about it?
Nothing, you angry man. I'm old enough to be your father.
England 7, Macedonia 0. And what a superb hat-trick by the young player and Arsenal winger, Saka.
His second goal was absolutely superb. The ball come through, he's chest it down, whop, right in the back of the net. Fantastic.
What a lovely week I'm having up here in the lochs in Scotland. It's so peaceful.
Oh, he's poking his head up. Oh my God, it's a Loch Ness Monster.
What a load of bloody rubbish.
This is Robert De Niro. I'd like to thank you for all the letters because I had a little boy and he looked at me and I said to him, are you looking at me?
Are you looking at me? Are you looking at me?
What do you mean, a clown? I'm funny? I make you laugh?
We need to get rid of these people.
There's no fun no more, is there? Where's me donut? Where is it?
Down your cake hole, you lunatic.
Ladies and gentlemen, with thousands in attendance and millions watching around the world, here's Johnny.
What's the matter, you? Hey, God, no respect. What do you think you do? Why you look so sad? It's a not so bad. It's a nicer place. I shut up for your face.
Mama, she said it all of the time.
You, what's the matter, you? Hey, God, no respect. What do you think you do? Why you look so sad? It's a not so bad. It's a nicer place. I shut up for your face.
Ladies and gentlemen, the show has been inundated with calls to come on the show to do some impressions. So, we've selected three people at random. We don't know what they're like, but anyway, the first one is Richard from Sussex, and he's a policeman, and he's going to impersonate Winston Churchill. Line one, who is it?
Winston Churchill.
Winston Churchill, are you still alive?
Yes, I'm alive.
And what would you like to say, Winston?
I just want to let you know, Johnny, that I have taken over as manager of Tottenham Hotspur.
Tottenham Hotspur, you're the manager. Winston Churchill, they need someone like you, someone who don't give up. And what are you going to do?
We are going to fight in Highbury. We're going to fight in Brighton. We're going to fight in Manchester United.
And what's the end bit? What's the big end bit you say in that big speech?
We will not surrender.
Yes! Winston Churchill. A second impressionist, ladies and gentlemen, is Luigi from Italy. And Luigi is going to impersonate Freddie Mercury. And Luigi works as a tax inspector. Quick, start running. Line two, who is it? Hail. Not Freddie Mercury. Hail. Oh, blimey, Freddie.
Just do as I say. Just warm up your vocals, Johnny.
Oh, blimey. Go on, Ed. Where you go?
Hail.
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 Edo, edo, edo. Edo, edo, edo.
Edo, edo. Edo, 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 edo. This is the big one, Johnny. This is the big one. Hail. Oh, blimey. I'll do this one. Oh, thank you, Freddie. Freddie, is it really you?
Yes, it's really me.
Can you ring up next week?
Yes, I will.
Thank you. Thank you, Freddie. And our third impersonator, ladies and gentlemen, is Ronnie from Highgate. And he's a burglar. We've got a tax inspector, a copper, and a burglar. And he's going to impersonate Rod Stewart. Line three, who is it?
Is that Johnny there?
Yes, it's Johnny. Who's that speaking?
it's Rod Stewart.
Hello, Rod. What are you doing ringing?
Well, you're Johnny. Look, I know that you're recording in the Ritz Hotel. You've got a studio at the top.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. What's the problem, Rod?
I'm dying to go a wee, and my belt's got caught, and so is my flyers, Johnny. Can you help me out?
Of course I can. Come right up. Come to the top. I can't believe it, Rod Stewart. Rod, I know you know the Ritz Hotel really well, but when you get in the revolving door, don't push it too fast because you'll go spinning round for ages. I know you know.
Thanks, Johnny. Thanks.
Are you all right, Rod?
Yeah, I'm okay now, Johnny. I'm okay. Do you know, Johnny, I didn't know where the studio was and I didn't know what day it was till I walked into the room.
I like that one, Rod. Rod Stewart, ladies and gentlemen. That's all three done, ladies and gentlemen. And now, our judge is going to vote on what one he thought was the best. So over to Simon Cowell. Simon.
Okay, I'm going to be totally honest. Winston Churchill, he was so bad that if I was under him as a soldier, I think before I got to the beach, I would have done a runner. And as from Ronnie from Highgate, I thought he sounded like he'd been stuck in a washing machine for a number of months. And also, I reminded me of Sean Dyche, the Burnley manager, having smoked 17 cigars and maybe he's got laryngitis. So my final man who I think should go through to the next round is Luigi from Italy, who played Freddie Mercury. So congratulations, and you're through to the next round. Thanks.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for everyone who took part in this, especially Simon Cowell.
And now over to Life in Scotland with Danny Griffin.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. And thank you for joining the show. Today, we're talking to the wee cranky. The wee cranky. Now, are you okay there?
Yes, I'm fine.
Now, I'd like to talk to you about you and your husband.
Ork, can't you leave him out of this conversation?
Well, no, because I want to talk to you about money has been missing from certain accounts in this country. £600,000 from an account. And when they went to see your husband and ask him about it, he said, oh, it's only borrowing. And he put it back in the proper account the next day. Now, can you try to explain that for me? Because I believe that you were arrested last week as well for the same thing.
Oh, no, I think you're getting it all wrong. Listen, in Scotland, you know, there's a thing called borrowing. And it's like when you're young, you might take £2 out of your mother's purse. She doesn't know about it, but by the time she gets in, you put the £2 back. So it's called borrowing.
Well, I don't think so. It's called stealing. And you're not supposed to take money out of various accounts. You should know that. You're a wee cranky.
Well, no, I totally disagree with you. You know, my husband is a very generous man, and the £600,000 that we... Oh, I shouldn't have said we. I put myself in it now. My husband took out of the account was for my daughter and a beautiful home in Tuscany that we were going to buy.
Well, this is what I'm actually saying. Things are not going very well in Scotland at the moment, especially with your family. You know, the wee crankies.
Well, money has been very tight for us lately. You know, when I went into the prison at the weekend, I was in the same cell as my husband was. And he put a sign there and it's got, I'm innocent of all charges.
But he'd not even been charged.
Oh, another mistake. But I thought, while I'm here, I don't want to just sit here and be bored all day. So I drew a beautiful picture of me and my husband, and I want to make it like, you know, like a Banksy. Could be worth millions in time to come. But I've called it the wee cranky.
Well, let's just finish off with, you know, at your age, you and your husband, you're not supposed to go taking money out of other people's accounts, and especially out your mother's purse.
Yes, well, if anyone's upset about it, I do apologise, but please keep listening to me and watching me on Twitter. So from me, the wee cranky, thank you.
And from me, Danny Griffin, from a cranky, cranky, cranky. Thanks, John. Back over to you.
Let's go over to our weatherman, Boomer,
thank you. Thank you very much, Johnny. Just want to let you know, Johnny, that I'm not doing the weather no more.
I'm not doing the weather. I've got a new job in the House of Commons. I've opened up a bar there, a bar in the House of Commons, and it's called Boomer Spoons. You know, weather spoons. This is Boomer Spoons. And I've only been doing working at the bar for about 4 days, and I've sold out every day. Blimey, these politicians, they drink like bloody fish. They don't stop, especially the young women. Bloody hell, they get like 2 drinks down them and they start dancing and twisting and hollering and shouting. And then the men get drunk on 1 pint of lager and they're dancing all over the place. And that's not in a private flat or in a house. It's bloody in the House of Commons. So also, I'm working as a part-time spy. I have to tell the leaders, the old man at the back with the grey hair, I have to tell them, you know, what's up. But I keep you informed, this is Boomer, new spy, and the new pub in the Houses of Parliament is called Boomer Spoon. Thank you. Yeah, my mama, she told me. And now, ladies and gentlemen, over to our boxing correspondent. We look forward to him every week. It's John Fury, ladies and gentlemen. John Fury. How are you, John?
Yeah, I'm great. I'm great, John.
Well, listen, what you've been up to this week? Hopefully things have been nice with your grandchildren and Tyson and everything.
Yes, you know, life is good. And but all it needs every now and then is someone to spoil the party.
What do you mean, John? It seems like someone's upset you. What's happened?
Well, let me tell you this, John. I think I know yes, yes, and I know no, and I know right from wrong. And I'm very nice to people, unless they get a bit aggressive towards me.
What's happened, John?
Well, the gas man came in on Monday, and he said to me, you should be reading this meter and sending it off to us. So I said, and he said, like I just said, do you want me to repeat it? Well, without thinking, the red mist went up in my head, and before I knew it, I was knocking 6 bells out of him, and he was flat on the floor in the front room. And then he got up, and he apologised. He was like a wimp. He was just on his knees. He was apologising, don't hit me again. And then he said, hang on a minute. He said, oh, he said, I do apologise. He said, I'm at the wrong door. He said, you John Fury? I said, yes. He said, oh, you sent me on in last week, didn't you? I said, yes. I said, now, through being a big pig-headed idiot, you've got yourself a bloody hiding. That's taught him a lesson in life.
John, you are so right. He made a big mistake, and you've taught him a lesson there, John. He won't do it again, will he?
Well, if he does, and he comes round here, he'll get another clatter of bloody bish, bash, bosh, bish, bash, bosh, right round his head. And he knows that I'm a good fighter. He knows it. And at the end, he said, he done something to the meter. I said, what are you doing? He said, I'm doing this. And he twisted something. And he said, from now on, Mr. Fury, I made a big mistake today. He said, you won't pay for no more gas. Well, I gave him a cup of tea and a biscuit. And he went out very, very nice. Very nice. He should have done that in the first place, John. Because I get upset. It's like me being in here now. I'm getting worked up.
John, don't say,
oh, don't talk to me like that.
Fancy some fish and chips, John.
Oh, that'll be lovely, John. That'll be lovely.
Ladies and gentlemen, my guest, my favourite guest every week, John Fury. Ladies and gentlemen, our next guest is a fantastic actor. He loves his football. He's a West Ham supporter. Ladies and gentlemen, Ray Winston. All right, Ray, how's it going, mate?
Yeah, I'm doing all right, Johnny.
Right, Ray, first of all, West Ham with Declan Rice. What's the situation with you?
Right, let me tell you something now, all right? He don't go. He ain't going to go nowhere. Because if he does, then he'll have to face me. And he's got to understand that. I've been a West Ham supporter for years. I've played on the pitch. I've scored goals there. And I've done other things because I love this club. But if he leaves, there's going to be trouble.
But can't you understand, Ray, that he's at a club, really, that is not going to win no league medals or win the title?
What are you on about? Why are you being so negative, all right? Don't talk like that about my team, West Ham. Well, I'm just saying, you know, the boy wants to win some medals in there. Right, let me tell you something. If he goes, he's probably going to go to Arsenal or Man City. I mean, I ain't spoke to him yet. I ain't seen him. But what I am saying is that if he does leave West Ham, he's got to speak to me first, because I'm the daddy. And when I say speak to me first, that means whatever he goes for, if it's 100 million to Arsenal, then I want at least 50% of that. And if he goes to Man City, then I want at least 60% of that. So I don't hold no grudges if he gives me some dosh when he does leave.
And if he don't pay you the dosh?
Well, he will get a few ice creams in his boat race, won't he?
Thanks very much, Ray Winston, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, God, I hope you don't bash into John Fury on the way out.
Who's that? Who's that over there? Who mentioned my name?
What? You want some?
Cat! Stop it! Sorry! Cat! I'll get you down there! I'll get you! Come here!
Line four, that's... Oh, Roger from Hackney! Hello, Roger, how are you?
I'm all right, Johnny, thank you very much.
Well, what have you been up to?
Listening to your show. And, you know, I see all the impersonators, Winston Churchill, I didn't think much of him. Didn't think much of Rod Stewart, although I thought my voice sounded like his.
Yes, it did, actually. Yeah, it did.
I liked the Freddie Mercury one. I like that, but I'm a bit down at the moment. You know,
what's the problem? What's the problem?
Well, I'm looking forward to going to Southend today on my bike, and I got a puncture. So I've thrown it in the bloody dustbin.
Well, Roger, look, just try and calm down.
I just rang you up, John. I listen to your show regularly. Is there any jobs going at your in the studios where you work in the Ritz? I know it's the Ritz Hotel. You're at the top floor.
Well, the thing is, at the moment, Malcolm is the team man. You know Malcolm, didn't you? He's over there.
Hello, Johnny.
Hey, that's Malcolm.
Hello. How you doing, Roger?
Yeah, I'm fine, thank you.
And the thing is, Roger, I can see what I can do. What would you say you're talented at?
Well, I would love, when you're having these conversations with people, I would love to get involved in the conversations. John Fury, I like him, but I'd like to put him in his place now and then.
Oh, that's that would be a bit dangerous, wouldn't it?
Well, no, not the way I said. I love the discussion with the crankies. I totally agree with you. I totally agree. And if there's any jobs going, John, I really appreciate it.
Okay, Roger, that's line four. That's Roger from Hackney. Ladies and gentlemen, I've thoroughly enjoyed the show. The show will now go on Twitter. There'll be a link to YouTube. And I'd love you to keep listening to the show, because, ladies and gentlemen, until I see you next week, shut up your face!
Hello, everybody. That's out there on the radio and the TV land. Did you know I had the big hit the song in Italy with this? Shut up your face. I sing this song, all of my fans applaud, they clap their hands. But they're making me feel so good. You ought to learn that this song, it's a real simple. See, I sing, what's the matter, you? Sing, hey, then I sing the rest, and then at the end we can all sing, ah, shut up your face. Okay, let's try it really. Uno, due, tre, what's the matter, you?
Hey,
God, and no respect.
Hey,
what do you think you do?
Hey,
why you look so sad?
Hey,
it's not so bad.
Hey,
it's a nicer place.
Ah, shut up your face.
That's great. We're gonna do the better this time. I bet. Hey, what's the matter, you?
Hey,
God, and no respect.
Hey,
what do you think you do?
Hey,
why you look so sad?
Hey,
it's not so bad.
Hey,
it's a nicer place.
Ah, shut up your face.
Okay, one time for Mama, everybody. What's the matter, you?
Hey,
God, and no respect.
Hey,
what do you think you do?
Hey,
why you look so sad?